بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. جامعة بنها، كلية الهندسة ببنها، البرامج العلمية المتخصصة بنظام الساعات المعتمدة، برنامج هندسة وإدارة التشييد فصل الربيع، كورس تايتل Accounting. Lecture number 5، Cost Volume Profit Analysis. We discussed earlier total revenues, total costs, and income. Cost volume profit analysis studies the relationship between these elements as changes occur in the unit sold, selling price, variable cost per unit, or the fixed cost of a product. So, cost volume profit analysis assists managers in understanding the behavior of a product or service's total cost, total revenue, and operating income. As changes occur in the output level, selling price, variable cost, or fixed cost. Here, the manager begins by identifying which costs are fixed and which costs are variable, and then calculate contribution margin. The first learning objective, understanding the assumptions underlying cost volume profit analysis. First assumption, changes in the level of revenues and costs arise only because of changes in the number of units produced and sold. So, the reason for changing in total revenue or total cost arise from changes in the quantity of units produced or sold. Second assumption, total cost can be divided into a fixed component and a component that is variable with respect to the level of output. As total cost equals variable cost plus fixed cost, variable cost is changes in total in proportion to changes in the related level of total activity or volume. Fixed cost remains unchanged in total for a given time period by avoid changes in the related level of total activity or volume. Third assumption, when graphed, the behavior of total revenues and total costs is linear. That can be expressed in straight lines in relation to output units within the relevant range and time series. The fourth assumption, the unit selling price, unit variable cost, and total fixed cost are known and constant. Cost volume profit assumption and terminology. Operating income equals total revenue from operations minus COGS and operating costs. When operating income equals total revenue minus total cost, net income equals operating income minus income tax. Explain the features of cost volume profit analysis. You should explain how operating income changes with change in output level, or change in selling price, or change in variable cost, or change in total fixed cost. Cost volume profit analysis example. Assume that the bank shop can purchase pants for $32 from a local factory. Other variable costs amount to $10 per unit. So the variable cost per unit equals $32 plus $10 equals $42. The local factory allows the pant shop to return all unsold pants and receive a full $32 refund per pair of pants within 1 year. The average selling price per pair of pants is $70 and total fixed cost amounts $84,000. How much revenue will the business receive if 2,500 units are sold? We have purchase price and other variable cost per unit equal $42 as variable cost per unit and $70 as selling price per unit and $84,000 as total fixed cost. So total revenue equals selling price per unit multiplied by quantity of units sold equals 2,500 units multiplied by $70 equals $175,000. How much variable cost will the business incur? Variable cost equal variable cost per unit, which is fixed per unit, equal $42 multiplied by quantity of units sold 2,500 units equals $105,000 as total variable cost. Here the operating income equal total revenues minus total cost. Total revenues $175,000. Total cost variable cost $105,000 minus $84,000 as fixed cost. So operating loss equals $14,000. Contribution margin. What is the meaning of contribution margin? Contribution margin is the difference between total revenues and total variable costs. Contribution margin equals total revenues minus total variable costs. So contribution margin per unit equals selling price minus variable cost per unit. Contribution margin per unit equals selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. We can calculate contribution margin by using contribution margin per unit and multiply contribution margin per unit by number of units sold. Contribution margin percentage, or called contribution margin ratio, is the contribution margin per dollar of revenue. Contribution margin percentage equal contribution margin per unit divided by selling price per unit. In the previous example, what is the contribution margin per unit? Contribution margin per unit equals selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit equals $70 as selling price per unit minus $42 as variable cost per unit equals $28 contribution margin per unit. This means that contribution margin per unit will recover $28 for each pair of pants of fixed cost. So we need to fully recover the $84,000 fixed cost and then obtain revenue. What is the total contribution margin when 2,500 pairs of pants or sold. Total contribution margin equal contribution margin per unit multiplied by number of units sold. 2,500 units multiplied by $28 equals $70,000. Contribution margin percentage is the contribution margin per unit divided by the selling price per unit. What is the contribution margin percentage? Contribution margin per unit equals $28 divided by selling price per unit equals $70. So contribution margin percentage equals 40%. If the business sells 3,000 pairs of pants, revenues will be $210,000. Because total revenues equal selling price per unit multiplied by number of units sold equals $70 as selling price per unit multiplied by 3,000 units as number of units sold equals $210,000. And the contribution margin would equal 40% multiplied by $210,000 equal $84,000, because contribution margin can be calculated from contribution margin percentage by multiplied contribution margin percentage by total revenue. We can calculate contribution margin. Determine the break-even point and output level needed to achieve a target operating income using the three methods: the equation method, contribution margin method, and the graph method. What is the meaning of break-even point? Break-even point is the quantity of output sold at which total revenues equal total cost. That is the quantity of output sold or number of units sold that results in zero operating income. What is the number of units needed to be sold to break even? What is the number of units needed to be sold to have $0 as operating income? At break-even point, sales revenue minus variable cost equals fixed cost. We have total revenue equals total cost. At break-even point, total revenue equals total cost. Total revenue minus total cost equals zero. Total revenue minus total cost is as variable cost plus fixed cost. So total revenue minus variable cost minus fixed cost equals zero. Total revenue equals selling price per unit multiplied by number of units sold or quantity of units sold. Variable cost equal variable cost per unit multiplied by Q as quantity sold minus fixed cost equal zero at break even point. We have some abbreviation. SB selling price per unit, VCU variable cost per unit, CMU contribution margin per unit, CM percent contribution margin percentage, FC fixed cost, Q quantity of output units manufactured and sold. OI operating income, TOI target operating income, TNI target net income. Equation method. Selling price per unit multiplied by quantity sold as total revenues minus variable unit cost multiplied by quantity sold as variable cost minus fixed cost equals operating income. Let U number of units sold to break even. We substitute in the previous equation $70 as selling price per unit multiplied by Q as quantity sold minus $42 variable cost per unit multiplied by Q minus $84,000 as fixed cost equals 0 to break even. We want to know the number of units needed to be sold to break even. $28 Q equals $84,000. So the quantity of units needed to be sold to break even equals 3,000 units. And 3,000 units as break even, total revenues equals total cost. So there is neither profit nor loss at this even point. If the company sells fewer than 3,000 units, it will incur a loss. But if it sells 3,000 units, it will break even. And if the company sells more than 3,000 units, it will make a profit. The second method is contribution margin method. We can calculate the even number of units and break even revenue. Break even number of units equal fixed cost divided by contribution margin per unit. Equal $84,000 as fixed cost divided by $28 as contribution margin per unit. So break even number of units equals 3,000 units. Break even revenues equal fixed cost divided by contribution margin percentage. Equal fixed cost divided by contribution margin percentage. So break-even revenues equals $84,000 divided by 40% equals $210,000. $210,000 is operating revenue or sales revenue at break-even point, and 3,000 units at break-even point. If the company sells 3,000 units, there is no neither profit nor loss. We can prove this equation by substitute in the income statement or contribution margin statement. Sales revenues minus variable cost equal contribution margin minus fixed cost equal operating income. If we substitute by 3,000 units and reach to operating income equal 0, so here is the break even point. By substituting sales revenues equal selling price per unit multiplied by number of units sold, 3,000 units multiplied by $70 as selling price per unit equals $210,000. Minus variable cost equals 3,000 units sold multiplied by $42 as variable cost per unit equals $126,000. Then contribution margin equal $84,000minus fixed cost $84,000. So operating income is here we have in the break-even point. There is neither profit nor loss. Total revenues equal total cost. Operating income equal zero. Graph method. In the graph method, we represent total cost and total revenues graphically. Each is shown as a line on a graph, as a straight line. Total revenue is a straight line, yellow straight line. Total cost is a green straight line. Fixed cost is the blue straight line, which is parallel to itself. Total cost line is the sum of fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed costs are $84,000 for all quantities of units sold within the relevant range. So when fixed cost equal $84,000 at any point, if we have 0 units sold, total cost equal $84,000 because variable cost is 0 and fixed cost equal $84,000. So total cost equal $84,000 when there is no units sold, when number of units sold equal 0. If we choose any other output level, say 1,000 units sold, and determine the corresponding total cost, when total cost equal variable cost plus fixed cost, variable cost equal 1,000 units multiplied by $42 as variable cost per unit equal $42,000. Plus fixed cost $84,000, then total cost equal $126,000 as 1,000 units sold. The total cost line is a straight line begin from $84,000 as fixed cost. This is the line or straight line for total cost. Total revenues line. One convenient starting point is zero. $0 revenues as 0 units sold. If there is no units sold, there is no revenue for the company. Select any other output level, determine the corresponding total revenues as. So we can say 2,000 units is number of units sold. Total revenue is equal 2,000 units multiplied by $70 as selling price per unit. Total revenue is equal $140,000. If the company sells 2,000 units, the total revenue is equal $140,000. Also, the total revenue line is a straight line begins from $0. Profit or loss at any sales level can be determined by the vertical distance between two lines at that level, between total cost line and total revenue line. For quantities fewer than 3,000 units, total cost exceeds total revenue, then the area indicates operating loss. the area before break-even point indicates operating losses. For quantities greater than 3,000 units, total revenues more than total cost, so the area indicates operating income or operating profit. At 3,000 units, so total revenues equal total cost, there is neither profit nor loss. It is the point of break-even. When the break-even point tells us or tells managers how much they must sell to avoid a loss. Managers are equally interested in how they will achieve the operating income target underlying their strategies and plans. We have target operating income. The target operating income, the point at which we realize target operating income equal fixed cost plus target operating income the company needs to achieve, divided either by contribution margin percentage or contribution margin per unit. Quantity of units required to be sold to achieve target operating income equals fixed cost plus target operating income divided by contribution margin per unit. Revenues needed to earn operating income equal fixed cost plus target operating income divided by contribution margin percentage. Assume that management wants to have an operating income of $14,000. If the company wants to realize target operating income equal $14,000, so it is equal fixed cost plus target operating income divided by contribution margin per unit. How many pairs of pants must be sold? Here we need the quantity of units required to be sold to realize $14,000 as target operating income equal $84,000 as fixed cost plus $14,000 target operating income divided by $28 contribution margin per unit. Here, number of units needed to be sold equals 3,500 units. What dollar sales are needed to achieve this income? We want to determine revenues needed to earn target operating income equal $14,000. Fixed cost plus target operating income divided by contribution margin percentage. $84,000 as fixed cost plus $14,000 target operating income divided by 40% contribution margin percentage equals $245,000. We need to prove that if the company produces and sells 3,500 units, the operating income equals $14,000 and total revenues equals $245,000. The contribution margin statement or income statement, sales revenue minus variable cost equal contribution margin minus fixed cost equal operating income. If the company sells 3,500 units, it has sales revenue $245,000. If it sells 3,500 units, the variable cost equals $147,000. Then contribution margin equals $98,000 minus fixed cost $84,000. The operating income is $14,000. As target operating income, the company needs to achieve. Then we illustrated target operating income to answer the question, how many units must the company sell to earn an operating income of $14,000? Thank you for good listening.